Hello, aspirants. Looking at current affairs for 17th Jan, the news items picked up from the Hindu newspaper are these nine. We look at them in detail. The first one, CJI meets judges, initiates dialogue. So this we have seen the rift between the CJI and four senior most judges after him in the Supreme Court has been evident with them coming with a briefing with the media on 12th January. So here CJI met with his four senior most colleagues to initiate a discussion on issues which were highlighted by him in this press conference. So now it is expected that an outcome and will come forth and things would be sorted out. Then next is government to revisit Malimath report. So this is the report of Justice Malimath committee, which was a committee on reforms of the criminal justice system. This committee was constituted by Home Ministry in 2000. By then Deputy Prime Minister L.K. Advani, and it gave its report in 2003. But none of its recommendations have been accepted so far. No decision has been taken on them. And now this report was put forth and discussed at the annual DGP, Director General of Police Conference, which was held in Jan 2018 in MP. So here the Prime Minister Narendra Modi was also present, and these 158 recommendations which have never been implemented, well, so discussions on some of them took place, and also now it is being stated that if the government would consider whether it can be implemented or not. So prominent reforms which were highlighted from this Malimath report are regarding reforms in criminal justice system, like admissibility of confessions made before a police officer as evidence in a court of law. So this confession is actually not admissible presently, but the committee recommended that it should be admissible because coercion is also used by police officers to extract, you know, evidences. Also, it had recommended that a national judicial commission should be established, amending Article 124 to so that impeachment of judges becomes less difficult. So this we have already seen, the Supreme Court has actually rejected national judicial commission. National Judicial Appointment Commission, as we have seen, NJAC. So these are some key recommendations you can see. That confessions before an SP rank officer be admitted as evidence. Standard of proof beyond reasonable doubt followed in criminal cases should be done away with was another recommendation. Also, for false registration of cases, it said there should be a stringent punishment. So such were the recommendations here. Then next is Haj subsidies to end, Naqvi. So this is Union Minister of Minority Affairs who has announced that the central government would phase out subsidies for annual Haj pilgrimage for Muslims. So actually in 2012, Supreme Court had ordered that the subsidies be phased out by 2022, but the government has achieved it much before that. And the Supreme Court had also stated that the money saved out of this, that is around 450 crores annually, which is spent, this money should be spent and diverted for welfare-oriented activities. So the government had earlier also stated it will be using this for education of girl child, but presently steps have been taken to phase out annual Hajj pilgrimage. So a committee was also set up which also suggested other reforms, like women Hajis should be allowed pilgrimage without male escort, which is called a mihram. So this has also been recommended and put into effect. Then next is missing the grass for the trees in Western Ghats. So in the Western Ghats, it has been seen that the trees, the Shola trees, have been saved, but the grass, Shola grasslands, have suffered. So there is expansion of agriculture, even timber plantation has expanded, even invasive species have spread in these regions. These are said to be the three prominent reasons because of which the grasslands here in Western Ghats, especially in the Palni hill range of Western Ghats, has seen a decline by 2/3. So this is being highlighted by a study. So here you can see invasive species, most prominent amongst these is the seed producer acacia. So this is being highlighted. So these Shola grasslands, and all this data has come through satellite imagery. So the range of this Palni hill range as such is prominent for the famous hill station Kodaikanal. So in this region you can see that Shola grasslands have declined by 66.7%. So these Shola grasslands means stunted forest growths of diverse grass species. They have been suffering. So these are critical habitats for many species, and they are seen as lower priority presently. The prominent species here, endemic like Nilgiri pipit, which is a bird, is also under threat because of this. So means forest conservation are highlighted, but grasslands are not. Then next is 1.2 lakh fewer deaths in under 5 category in 2016. So the latest data shows that under 5 mortality rate, infant mortality rate, has seen the sharpest year-on-year decline since 2010 for the year 2016. So under 5 mortality rate in the country is 39 per 1000 live births, 39 deaths. So this is very low compared to 2015 data of 43 also. So this means around 1,20,000 fewer deaths have occurred for the year. There is a drastic variation, like in urban areas, it is 25, and in rural areas, it is 43. Even from state to state, it varies, like in Kerala, it is 11 deaths per 1,000 live births, but in Madhya Pradesh, it is 55. Also, another thing seen is there's higher under 5 mortality rates among girls than boys in almost all bigger states and union territories except Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh. So this is the data here. Then next is, Supreme Court orders Maharashtra government to share all records on Judge Loya's death to petitioners. So this is regarding Judge Loya, the case which has been highlighted by the four senior most judges as such too in the press conference. So this Justice Loya, Judge Loya, was actually a CBI judge who was sitting on the case, hearing the case on Sohrabuddin encounter, in which BJP President Amit Shah was also an accused. So various police officers and BJP president were named as, you know, guilty, as accused in the case. And Justice Loya died in mysterious circumstances in December 2014. So an investigation has been sought in this matter. A PIL petitions have been filed as such, seeking a CBI probe in this matter. A two-judge bench is hearing this case, but then the two-judge bench has also said that they will put forward this case before an appropriate bench. So it means they may not want to hear the case further because of the allegations which have been raised is clear here. So Supreme Court presently in this case, the bench said that Maharashtra government should share all documents linked to the death of CBI Judge B.H. Loya before the PIL petitioners. Though it said that the content should not be made public by the petitioners as well. So this is the issue here. Then next is, water scarcity may hit thermal power. So India's thermal power plants, about 90% of them rely on fresh water for cooling. So when fresh water is in deficit, then these thermal power plants also face serious outages. So this results in around, it is said that 14 out of India's 20 largest thermal utility companies have experienced one or more shutdowns because of water shortages. This is a loss of about 14 terawatt hours of thermal power generation. So this is of huge concern. So it has resulted in more than 20% growth in the country of total energy generation, electricity generation in the country as such being reduced. So even in water abundant and low water stress regions also, it has been seen that water shortage is evident during times of droughts and even when monsoons are delayed. So this is a concern which has been highlighted as such in this report by World Resources Institute. And it says that by 2030 in India, 70% of thermal power plants will experience increased competition for water because fresh water is required by agriculture, by industries, municipalities, and now these thermal power plants may suffer. Then next is, center to seek comments on farm export policy draft. So the Commerce Ministry will soon put out a draft agricultural export policy for comments from the public. So it aims to boost shipments of farm items by identifying niche products and new markets. So for particular products, how value addition can be done, how wastage can be reduced, post-harvest interventions, pre-harvest interventions can be brought in, and agricultural export be promoted. So it will also help developing agricultural clusters, which has been emphasized on quite often earlier, even by Prime Minister, that the way there are clusters for industries, say there can be clusters for agriculture too. Areas which can form a niche area for particular form of agricultural produce. So such agricultural produce clusters should also be developed in the country is highlighted. It says farmers should also have a right to access global markets and get better prices. So the farmers themselves would benefit or the intermediaries would benefit is another matter. And the last news item is Australia to offer payment for Great Barrier Reef rescue ideas. So Australia is seeing the Great Barrier Reef suffering because of coral bleaching. The Great Barrier Reef is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. It is the world's largest coral reef as such too. And Australia has announced a fund for research for protecting this world's largest living structure. This is around $1.6 million fund has been announced. So this people who give out ideas for protecting the Great Barrier Reef, they can retain the intellectual property rights for the innovation too and commercialize it as well. And they'll get this funding as well. So the coral bleaching which is taking place in the Great Barrier Reef is due to warm sea temperatures, and this is linked to climate change. Also, farming runoff, then development in the adjoining region, as well as the predatory species of corals, that is crown of thorn starfish, are a matter of concern here, and they are causing irreparable damage to the Great Barrier Reef. It's a huge region, around 2,300 km region, which is suffering for the second straight year in 2016 because of 2017 because of bleaching by warm sea temperatures. So here you should understand what is coral bleaching. We have seen what are corals quite often earlier. So there are these corals which secrete, you know, the carbonate secretion which is there. So there are these algae, zooxanthellae, which live in these corals, and they conduct photosynthesis and help in providing food for the corals as well. But when the atmosphere, the region, climate as such, atmosphere is not favorable, like when ocean temperatures are high, or there is runoff and pollution in the water, or there is overexposure to sunlight, and in such cases the algae leave the corals. The coral gets stressed and algae, zooxanthellae, leave the corals, because of which the color which the corals have goes, and that is, these are the bleached corals, and then they do not get food because it's a symbiotic relation between the two, algae and the corals. So because of this they get bleached and eventually they don't get food and they die. So this is coral bleaching. So they can actually recover if coral bleaching, there's a time given for recovery, but then if there is successive coral bleaching taking place, then it is irreparable damage which is occurs on the corals. So this is it. Thank you.